and welcome to another episode of Lemur's Corner. Today, guys, we're going to be talking about what happened on PvP Season 2. Basically, in a nutshell, we ended up getting banned. We weren't really breaking any rules. The major issue that ended up happening was the server switched hosts, and then when I told them they had the settings wrong and stuff, and we tried to discuss it with them, they decided that we were idiots and didn't know what we were talking about when they had 6 people on and people had over 90 ping and stuff. It was terrible. So basically we said, we can't keep playing on there. And they were like, well, you know, that's not our fault. So you just need to deal with it. And they wiped everything from everyone and all kinds of issues. So basically we just got banned from there. Literally we are banned. We're not allowed to go back to that server. I will still post it, but I'm going to post it as the banned season rather than season 2, since it's only going to be a couple episodes, us building boats and raiding and stuff like that. There's still some good footage in there, so I'll get it out there to you guys. However, that means we have to start a brand new season. So this is going to technically be the real season 2. It's going to be on my own server, my personal server. It's much better. I get like a 16 ping on there, no worries. As you guys can see, I'm just kind of floating in midair here. We decided that we're going to do it on the island. We said we were going to do it on Scorched Earth, but we were going to bring in all tech gear and stuff so people could get tech gear on Scorched Earth and everything. And really, you can't use the engrams even because of the issue with the bosses, and then you can't spawn in the bosses in there from the Brewmother and everything with all the new tech underwater stuff. We decided to go to the island, and we'll just bring bring wyverns and stuff to the island. So basically, we had to build a marketplace. So the server's coming out tomorrow, actually, at 3 o'clock in the afternoon is when my goal is to get it rocking and rolling. It's going to be fresh start. I'll give stats in there, which means you guys can come and join it if you want to. There's not a ton of people on there. I will post the server name on there briefly, and then you guys can go ahead and add it, and you guys can come PvP with me if you want to. And have some fun. So let's go ahead and I'll go show you guys what we did. This is not on my actual main account. This is on my Lemur's Corner account. I just kind of want to float over here. I'm going to kind of hide it from you guys so you guys can see this awesome marketplace we built for trading and coming up with we're going to still come up with an economy system. But here it is. This is the landing platform here, guys. You land here with your Quetzals and stuff. We still have the ground one to work on, but you guys can see how awesome this thing looks. Obviously, you can come in here. Our little entrance sign with our little things, it came out pretty perfectly here. And the wyvern bites. I had help from Alpha Eagle and from Deadly. And basically, what we did is we decided to take over this spot, and it's a nice little trading post. You can see he made little cages over here showing some of the stuff we could bring in, rock elementals in there. Hello, Mr. Rock Elemental. We've got the fire wyvern. We've got all the trophies. The torches going. We've got the queues. You trade your stuff over here. Don't be shocked that there's a couple more modifications in here. I am on fly, so if you guys see me bouncing around a little bit, that's why I'm not used to it at all. So you guys can see we got a nice little trading center in here. We got some dinos back here to show it. You can see there's a trough hidden in the area. We've got our tech generator just to make sure it's safe. So we'll go ahead and activate that baby so we can protect it. Because if you have a tech generator that's a shield, no one can break in without killing the tech generator first. So that's kind of how that's going to work. But basically, you guys can come back here. You guys can see we've got torches and stuff everywhere. But basically, that's the entrance. And that's where we take like the orders and everything. We're going to have notes with stuff out there that people put the orders down what they want. Then we go around and back. So if you come with me, I did build those systems. We'll give you guys a nice overview on the inside part. And then you come back here. You can see like the wyvern and stuff is like a little caging thing. You guys can see back here. I stuck a little flag back there and everything. And you come back here, and this is where we're actually going to spawn all the stuff in, the wyverns and everything. So it's kind of sealed. You guys can see it's kind of a cathedral-looking ceiling. It's kind of cool. It was a lot of fun to build, guys. We had a lot of blast doing it. And I'll show you guys, as I said, kind of out here. There's, I don't know if you saw it, there's a lighthouse beacon. I'll show everyone where it's at, too. Those are actually all the heads you guys can get, if you didn't know. There's Manticore in the middle. Death worms, alpha wyvern heads, and all that kind of fun stuff. We'll probably end up doing events on here too eventually. This is going to probably be a longer stay on the island, having fun, constant PvP, early game, late game, all that kind of fun stuff. But let's just go ahead and jump out here and give you guys a good idea of what this thing actually looks like from the outside. I should show you guys my little lighthouse beacon. There it is right there. You guys can kind of see how it's right there. There's actually a text transmitter in there. It looks really kind of cool, I thought. And we kind of went for like a unique design on this stuff. Nothing's completely done. We see some of the tips and tricks we talked about in some of our building materials, these cages. Deadly did the cages in all tech. Eagle worked on the platform over there. We all worked on the foundation, and most of my job was building this building over here, minus the little entrances stuff. But that's what it is. It's really cool looking. I think it looks really awesome. But we're excited to get this going tomorrow. I hope you guys are going to jump in, some of you, hopefully. I'm going to try to get a couple other YouTubers in here, one of which I'll try to get Neon Dragon. I know he plays. I don't know how much he's going to play Ark anymore. He's one of the guys that I'm going to try to get in here. There's a guy named Delote. I'm going to send him a message and get him in here. It was kind of a last-minute change, guys, to us going to the island. But we thought this thing's pretty cool, and we thought it'd be kind of fun to build, like, a cool marketplace. Once that shield goes up, everything's look cool. It's not overly boosted. It's a little bit quicker because, you know, we like to have it where you can do stuff a little bit faster, and it's not, you know, sitting here on the Stone Age for 10 years before you can even have a metal base or anything. But you guys can see, I'll just kind of give you guys a good overview of the base, continue to show you that stuff. I'm kind of waiting for that shield to pop up, too. But that's what it looks like. You guys can see we used pillars inside of walls with foundations all the way around here. Under here, there's pillars and walls and stuff all around here. And this was pillars. You can see how I pillared it. Kind of gave it a good look on here. But basically, we're going to be focusing on that stuff, guys, and really focusing on having fun with this server, staying on here for a while. As I said, it's my server. Anyone that's worried about internet access, I've got fiber with a gigabyte, so there's really no issues. I can go ahead and hit start real quick so you guys can see it. I've got a whole 18 ping right now, and that's actually a slow ping for myself on here. So I hope you guys see it. You guys also could see the name on there. So if anyone caught it, it's called Marvel Dead Lemur. You guys can go ahead and add it. I won't put it in the comments, too, if you guys want to jump in here. But basically, it's going to be fun. I hope you guys get in here and enjoy it with us. You guys can be a part of Season 3. You guys can come beat me up in PvP and everything, as I said I would. And I discussed it with you guys on the Scorched Earth. But as I said, there's a reason we're not doing Scorched Earth. I'm still going to do some Scorched Earth tutorials. We'll try to focus on that after I get done with all of these water tutorials, especially with everything that's happening with the leads. That's the giant tuna dinosaur. Basically, it's eating boats for people, so they're having a boat issue. And I also am going to probably be doing another video tomorrow. There was a secret update they did not tell everyone about that actually happened, and I can kind of let you guys know now, and I'll tell you again in another video. But basically, they changed the weight limits on dinosaurs, basically the ankylos, the dodecarises, and the woolly mammoths specifically. The woolly mammoths, the ankylos, and the dodecarises all got 75% weight reduction in their carrying of their specific item that they get. That means ankylos will get a 75% reduction in metal, dodecarises are getting a 75% reduction in weight for stone. So that means instead of weighing, you know, 100 pounds per metal, it's gonna, or 200 pounds per stack of raw metal, it's only gonna weigh 50 pounds, which means when we start doing those Quetzal scoops and stuff, it's gonna be great. Also, they said that on the Quetzals, when you jump off of them and they're just floating in the air, they gave back 50% of the stamina buff, meaning they're still going to lose stamina slowly when you're standing on just the platform and everything, but they gave back, it's only going to lose 50% faster. And there goes our shield up. It's fully up there. So it pretty much surrounds the entire base. It looks really cool coming out of here. When we're not here, obviously we can do it. It covers our dinos and everything. It doesn't cover everything, obviously. But, you know, it looks really good, and it covers the main stuff that we're really worried about. But this is really going to be kind of a no PvP zone. Everyone can kind of have fun in here, buy some stuff. And I hope you guys have enjoyed this. I apologize for not. That's why I've kind of delayed on bringing out PvP, guys, is I was trying to figure out what I was going to do when we got kicked out of there. It's been about a week now that we've been kicked out of there. That's why I've kind of stopped. If you remember, there was PvP videos coming nonstop, and then all of a sudden I just stopped. It was because we were trying to figure out what we were going to do, and that's why I focused on tutorials for a little bit. We're still going to keep doing tutorials. I'm going to try to get a couple PvP episodes out every week. I'm trying to get two out a week and try to focus on five tutorials the rest of the week, getting out tutorials. I know you guys have been liking those a lot, especially. But we still want to get some PvP videos out there so we can stay on the server for a lot longer. So, guys, hit me up. Subscribe or like to the channel. Let me know what you guys think, what you guys want to see, what tutorials. If you like this design or anything like that, I did not record the actual building of it or anything, but It's really cool. You can see we got torches everywhere and everything, and it came out really cool, and I think it's going to be really fun to see this expand, and you guys can get in here, buy some jerboas, which I was laughing the other day. My wife pointed it out. My dog, which I will post a picture now, looks exactly like a jerboa. Almost exactly. So I thought that was kind of funny. And those of you who are wondering, he's a Doberman Beagle. Basset Hound mix. But basically, guys, that's going to do it for me. I hope you guys are enjoying what's going on. As I said, subscribe, like to the channel. Let me know what you guys are thinking and everything. And I hope you guys will be following here for a while. I will see you guys on the next episode. And hopefully we'll see you on the server so you guys can either kill me or I can kill you. Or we can kill each other at the exact same time. Who knows? Could be fun. And we'll see you guys on the next update.